Welcome to Chem Spark, a simple place for all level of chemistry. So in our series of group theory, this is lecture number 6, and sorry for the delay. Okay, now in this lecture, basically it is a revision of previous lecture, what we have done in the last 5 lectures. Let us revise what we have done. So today's aim of this lecture is to find out the symmetry operation that can be generated by a given symmetry element. So these are some symmetry elements, and accordingly I have done with the operations. Now first is E. E is an identity operation where you give n number of times, you'll get the same structure. Okay. So when a molecule is given with E, for n number of times you'll get the same structure, that is E. Okay, identity molecule. Now when you talk about CN, that is proper axis of rotation, CN rotate till you get the original structure. So whenever it is CN raised to N, it will be always E. So you can generate N minus 1 operation to come up to a same similar equivalent structure. Now sigma is nothing but reflection plane, will generate only one operation. I is an inversion, will also generate only one operation. Now there's something called improper axis of rotation where you rotate first and then you reflect, so that an identity structure can be produced. Now there are two conditions where n is even and when n is odd. Now here we will talk about first with even one. S4, that indicates C4 and sigma, that is C4 and sigma. If I'll do this operation twice, like raised to 2, I have to give this also power 2. So if I'm giving individually by using law of indices, C4 2 sigma square, okay, this indicates it is E, because sigma applied twice gives E, so it is nothing but C4 raised to 2 and into E. But if you multiply this, you will get C4 twice, but this also indicates it is nothing but C2 axis. So S4 raised to 2, that indicates C2. Now similarly with S4 raised to 3, S4 raised to 3 can be S4 raised to cube. This can be given as C4 raised to cube and sigma cube. Now here I can write C4 cube as only C4 cube. But here for sigma, I can write sigma square into sigma by using law of indices. Now sigma square is nothing but E, and sigma is given as sigma. So here E will multiply with sigma to give you sigma. So the answer is C4 raised to 3 and sigma. Now when you talk about S4 raised to 4, when both of them are even, see, you split this into C4 raised to 4 and sigma 4. But sigma 4 is nothing but can be written as sigma square into sigma square. And C n raised to n is always E. So this becomes E, this becomes E, and this becomes E. So when you multiply 3 E's, you'll get E. So S4 raised to 4 is nothing but E. So in conclusion with this Sn, when Sn raised to n minus 1 operation is given, and when n is even, your Sn raised to n is equal to E always if n is even. Okay, now we'll talk about something related to odd, when n is odd. Okay, now S3 will give you C3 sigma. When you do S3 ka square, you will get C3 square and sigma square. Sigma square can be written as E, but C3 square cannot be written with any format. So it is only C3 square. Now S3 raised to 3, it is nothing but C3 raised to 3 and sigma raised to 3 cube. So here I can split this. This is nothing but E, because C n raised to n is always E. But sigma cube can be written as sigma square into sigma. So E into sigma is nothing but sigma. So C3 raised to 3 is always sigma. So odd is always sigma and even is always E. So now we'll talk about this S3, 4. Okay, C3, 4 and sigma 4. But this becomes E. But here I can write this as E, but I can write in this format C3 raised to 3 into C3. So C3 raised to 3 is nothing but Cn raised to n, so that is nothing but E. So this operation becomes C3 only. So rest examples you can solve and you can come up with a solution of by yourself. The conclusion says that you do S2n minus 1, see Sn2n minus 1 to reach E. So here Sn raised to 2n will give you E. That means if n is odd and if you multiply it with 2, you'll always end up getting even number. So if you multiply 3, 3 is odd, and multiply by 3 into 2 will give you 6, and 7 into 2 will always give you 14, and this is nothing but even. When Sn raised to 2 into n and n is odd will give you E. So now up till now we have done it in the last 5 lectures. Now in next part we'll combine the symmetry operation. Now, how do we combine this? We'll see in this example of water molecule. Like what I'm saying, what combination means kya hota hai? Like agar ek molecule has inversion also and rotation, principal axis of rotation also, and if it is sigma v and sigma v prime, ye hota kya hai? Ise kaise combine karke likhna hai? That will come up to do. Okay, so here we have water, and water, you all know that it has C2V. Now why it has C2V? Because it has Z2 axis, which is nothing but here. I can rotate it in this format. Okay, if I'm holding here and I'm holding it, I can rotate it in this format. Sigma V is nothing but a here molecular plane where it is passing from HOH, and sigma V prime is nothing but it is this mirror. You can see it from here. So this is there are four, and E is also there. E is an identity operation. So C2, sigma V and sigma V prime and E. So this is basically becomes C2V. Now, to be more precisely, why it is in group theory, why it is grouped totally. Now see, water has, we have a possible symmetry operation we can give as E. If I want to declare the plane correctly, C2Z plane, Z axis plane, okay. Now I am talking about the axis, okay, C2 axis, na? So I am talking about axis. So axis can be X, Y or Z. So if I am considering Z axis. Now sigma V is nothing but XZ plane. Okay, because we have X, Y, Z. So this is X, Y and Z. So I'm talking about in this format. Okay, and sigma V prime is Y, Z plane. So possible symmetry operation is this many. Now this has to be following certain rules. Like for example, properties. Now this is closure property. When you multiply sigma V and sigma V prime, you'll get C2 axis, and that is nothing but the part of your set. C2, when you multiply any of this thing, you will get, if you do two operation, you will get the next operation, that is nothing but closure property. Identity is also present. If you multiply this, you will get the same thing. If you multiply this, you will get the same thing. If you multiply this, you will get the same thing. So identity is also present. Sigma V and sigma V prime are their own inverse, so you can consider it in this format. And when you do two operation like C2Z and C2Z will give you identity. Matlab multiplying this on its own will give you identity. And associative law means what? If you multiply first this, like Bodmas rule, if you multiply this two and then you multiply this, you'll get the same structure, same thing when you multiply these two, and afterwards you multiply this. So this is an associative law. So basically this entire set or the elements of the set follows all these rules, and hence the point group of water molecule is nothing but C2V. Okay. Now, how do I determine the point group? Now, initially you have to follow this chart. Okay. Now, we'll initially first keep this chart, and then later on we'll use accordingly. Now, whenever you are determining a point group, you need to find out highest axis of rotation. And if highest axis of rotation you have got it, then you have to ask for any other axis of rotation is present. Any other axis of rotation or any other than your principal axis, if there is any other axis of rotation, you can rotate the molecule. If it is yes, then there would be certain point group and certain way to follow the chart. And if you then next option is you have to check with the mirror planes. If mirror planes are there, then you have to assign a particular group. Now suppose if you have a molecule, we'll start from here. The very first step is you ask the molecule whether there are special groups. Now special groups in the sense it has a linear molecule. If it is a linear molecule, then it might be uneven distribution. Like it might not be symmetry. Like for example, HCN molecule. So the point group will start with C infinity. And if it is symmetric molecule, it will start with D infinity. Now this also has got the reason. Now if this is oxygen and oxygen, O2. Oxygen and oxygen. So I can pass the principal axis in this format. Okay, this is one. Any other than principal axis, is there any axis of rotation? Yes, it is there. So there are two things. Okay, so basically it belongs to D point group. Okay, the second question, if the molecule is not linear, that means it might have multiple high orders. So you have to find out whether it is tetrahedral, octahedral, icosahedral, etc. So accordingly you have to substitute with this. Now if there are no special groups involved, that means you have to find out, you have to search for next step, that is step 2. You have to search for if there is no proper axis of rotation, if there is any other thing, like other special groups, for example, if we don't have proper axis of rotation, we might have inversion, we might have CS point group, and we might have C1. So if it is CI, that means only EN inversion is there. If it is CS, only EN sigma plane is there. And if it is C1, only E is there. If suppose this is also not present, then you have to move to step 3. Step 3 may either you can have CN axis, or CN axis might be present in both the thing, but only one CN axis, and there are no C2s that is perpendicular to CN. And if there are n C2s, that is perpendicular to CN. And if there are no C2s perpendicular to CN, that indicates that the point group will start with C. And if it is n C2s, that means the point group will start from D point group. Okay. And if there are nothing like that, it will start with SN. Okay. Now, we suppose you land up with saying that CN axis is present. Okay, it is a simple axis, CN axis is present. And there are no C2s present, no C2s that is perpendicular to CN. That means you land up with sigma H plane or sigma V plane. Or no sigma's plane, so that means it is only CN. And if it is N C2s axis perpendicular to CN, that means you will land with sigma H, sigma D and no sigmas. So that means it is DN. So if it is sigma H present with no C2s that is perpendicular to CN, that means it is CNH group. And if it is sigma V plane, then it is CNV group. And if it is no sigma planes, that means it is only CN group. Okay, and DNH, DND and DN. So you might have asking me one question that sigma H will have a preference, then you have sigma V and then you have sigma D as a preference. Okay, now C type point group, this is C type point group, and step 5 mein this is D point, D type point group. Thank you so much. We'll wait for the next thing to come up. We have a series for this. So we'll in next lecture, we'll take some of the examples and we'll proceed with the other things. Thank you so much.